Hey, welcome to The Six Inch Show, episode 112, the Star Wars Celebration special. I'm Fly Guy from FlyGuyToys.com, joined as always by Mr. Matt from Instagram.com/ Star Wars The Black Series, Toy Tribe, Six Inch Legends,
stuff.
And on and on and on and on and on. You know this guy, if you've watched 111 before. We've just been talking about Kenobi. Both enjoying it, I think, is a general fair comment. And I think we won't spoil anything because it's probably really early for a lot of people yet, especially those of you at Star Wars Celebration. Hello, everybody who's there, who's been pinging little notices here and there. And I know Red Strong 5 on Twitter. Nice to see you there. He's out scurrying around trying to get some toys and having fun. And it looks pretty busy. It looks quite good.
I think so. Do I say it now? Do I wait for the show? We're in the show.
What's that?
I'll save it for later. Celebration. Yeah.
Well, I spoke to the guys at the Dark Side Toys with, and they were running around the show as well, and they were saying mobbed. They've been very, very, very busy. So if you're there, the queues are everywhere. But yeah, some good guests, some good people. Obi-Wan was there himself to launch the show. Hugh McGregor and Hayden Christensen, and loads of other actors and bits and pieces. And we got a teaser trailer for your favorite Star Wars, I think, currently game on current consoles.
Yes.
Jedi Fallen Order, which, go and watch the trailer, although it's such a teaser. Do you know what's going on in that teaser?
No, I've got idea. I've got no idea who the Bacta tank clone, whatever it is, thing is. I've got no idea on that.
Interesting.
Like, I mean, it would have been more interesting, not interesting, but it would have been more how'd you say, Star Wars Echoes or whatever it is, if it was his master. Sure. But it's not his master in the tank, so
I know.
So we're not expected to know who it is, so I'm not sure what's going on, but I don't care, man. All I know is we're going to go from a PlayStation 4 game to a PlayStation 5 game in this universe. I'm ready for whatever the new upgrade and improvement is, the next gen. And apparently, I'll just say, apparently they're saying like coming 2023, but from a EA Games shareholders meeting or whatever, it was untitled franchise game March 2023. Like 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And the only franchise they've got within the reference of what they're talking about is Star Wars. So I think it's, according to their shareholders meeting, it'll be scheduled for March 2023, which makes sense because that's when Ahsoka's meant to be coming out.
Mm.
And they kind of like to bring games with TV show with, I think Fallen Order was with Mandalorian season one. Within a week of each other and all that. Nice. So I think they like to ride the wave of new content, or maybe it was one of the movies anyway.
I would love to see the actor that plays Cal Kestis and gets mocap.
What's his name? Someone Monaghan, Cameron Monaghan, I think.
Anyway, I would just love to see him even just turn up Nick Fury like at the end of a season to just him in real life, just to bring that kind of world together. That would be, I think the smart money would be on that, hopefully. Cameron.
See, this, yeah. So it would be good to see him somehow turn up in Kenobi because it's the same timeline. But
I mean,
if he does or doesn't, I'm kind of like, let the game exist and bring in a TV series, a one-off TV series to link it to whatever the game after Survivor is or whatever. Like, just let Cal have, you know, bring some Purge troopers onto screen and, you know, give us some.
Yeah, there was a nice stuff. Little spoiler, I won't say who it is, but there's a nice little cameo in episode 2 of very briefly on the ground begging.
Oh yeah, gotcha.
So that was a nice little cameo there for me. I was like, oh my god, that's awesome. But more of that hopefully. Anyway, we won't spoil anymore. Go watch Kenobi, enjoy it. It's nice to see some Star Wars on TV. It's nice to see Star Wars in conventions. It's nice to see Star Wars toys get talked about. Not a lot so far. This is Friday night US time. Actually Saturday morning US time, way early in terms of when you're recording the show. So there may be reveals on Saturday during the day of celebration and Sunday, but normally Saturday afternoon is the last kind of cutoff. So we'll see.
If there is, I'm going to back one reveal or something to tie in with something else that they're going to announce, just like they did, I think, at the last celebration or the celebration before, whatever it was, where it was like, here's all our reveals. We've done our panel. And it's like, oh, there's a new Thrawn book series coming and Timothy Zahn's here. And oh, by the way, we're bringing out the Thrawn figure.
Yep.
So that's the kind of out of panel announcement or reveal they'll do. But don't forget, we've also got another reveal coming on Wednesday, potentially.
Yeah, that's right.
Potentially. If it might not be Black Series, it could be something else. But potentially there's more for the next four Wednesdays.
Yeah.
To come.
Obi-Wan waffle machine for all we know. You never know quite with that kind of stuff, do you? But anyway. So episode 111 was only 5 days ago, so there's not a great deal of comments there, but some good stuff. We'll get a look at that. There is brand new 3.75-inch figures. We'll take a look at them too, just to give that comparison again to six-inch figures, and just some other stuff. There's not a great deal that this came out overall, so we'll just give you a quick rundown, including the Black Series FX lightsaber and stuff. I will just give you a quick look at everything that was revealed at Celebration. Let's go straight away to the comments from the past show first, and we'll see what you guys said. Principally, that was covering the Marvel Legends live stream reveals of recent. So let us bring that on the screen. Let me zoom in the comments, and hopefully you guys can see this a little better. Michael Bale, show regular, was our comment regular, was saying he was enjoying the show. Oh, thank you, man. He's really looking forward to these shows dropping, so keep up the great work. Thank you. Being a Spider-Man fan, I'm loving the 60 years anniversary program for Spider-Man Us 2. Thanks to Matt for sharing my Spider-Man photo. There you go. Mine was the Spider-Man with a custom battle damaged head with villains in the background. That was a cracking photo. I think we drooled all over that, Michael. So there you go. I didn't realize that was you. The Battlestar picked up a Mando Ahsoka this week, which is an absolutely awesome figure. It really is, truly. Despite how much they can annoy us as a company, the standard of figures, when we actually get them, that Hasbro producing at the moment has definitely gone to the next level. I agree. We are getting some good stuff here. And the Mandalorian Wave recently. Oh, wow. Early on in 111, you guys were discussing explicitly how many unit stores may commit and how much they may pay or not pay versus fan channel. I was thinking about hearing that about three questions, which hopefully with the experience you guys may be able to answer. Question one for the panel. How many figures would be produced for each character in a wave and distributed around the world? I think we covered this in a show a while back. And I think from memory, we said somewhere in the region of, it does depend upon the character and the wave, but I think you're talking about 30 to 50,000.
Yeah, I thought it was 50 to 80, but I think 50 is around the number, which would before they go back into reprint or whatever, reproduction.
I think it depends, the Battlestar, I think purely on the character, on the store that's buying it, what's going on. I think in terms of general waves, I think if you really think about all the countries in the world, the quantity of people who buy it, probably 50,000. We've seen some figures before floating around, some leaks here and there about overstock that Hasbro have had, and that gave us a little bit of an insight. I think we covered it in one of the previous episodes, and that gave us an insight that they had made a lot of figures on some of them and a whole lot less on others. So might even be 10,000 for a very specific one of figures, because they might be limited to the US. But maybe a global figure, say like Ahsoka or something, I don't know, maybe 50,000, maybe 80,000, we don't quite know, but certainly not that small, that's for sure. Which is why they've got to get money at the mold and they've got to make a profit. So question two was, would more of certain characters be made than others? 100%. E.g. Boba Fett, Return of the Jedi, General Mando. Jin and Cassian versus Fennec, Mando, Ahsoka, and Boba Tython? Yes, I would say, because they're all different, whether it's in a wave and a case.
Although Boba Tython is a Target exclusive, so...
But yeah, true.
So that would be smaller, but yeah. Jin and Cassian, there was a shitload of them, mate.
Yep, that's for sure. Mando, Ahsoka.
Fennec and Mando, Ahsoka were all in mainline waves. Yeah. So I'd say they're more, but I'd say Return of the Jedi, Boba Fett would have been a shitload.
Yeah.
January 2 years ago.
Yeah, 80,000. And it's still in stock at some places. So
yeah,
that would be a larger.
And almost everybody's got one.
Nearly.
So, but they can still sell it. It has to be, 100%, but that just means it's at the very high end of.
Yes,
production, unlike something like which came out at the same kind of release was the Jar Jar Binks, which hung around as a bit of a peg warmer and a discounted one, but is now pretty much gone where Boba Fett's still there. So, you know, they made a lot more Boba Fett's than they did Jar Jar's.
I absolutely agree with you on that one. So, yeah, we're thinking some 50, some 80, maybe some less. Depending upon the character and the buy-in from channels and stores as well, because they do get feedback from their stores as to or the partners what potentially they would be interested in, we're sure. Would there be production budgets for each figure? There's absolutely production figures for or budgets for tooling, paint. General Gree was always an example. I remember just Steve Evans always talked about that quite openly. That
50 different paint applications or whatever it was. Yeah.
Paint's really, we've covered that many times before. Paint's really, really expensive. Not so much plastic these days. It's more about paint and the work required on the figure. Accessories, we know that's a kind of, weirdly though, it's not plastic kind of orientated so much. It seems to be a, I don't know, it's kind of weird to play. It's some they give and some they don't.
It's changing goalposts, that's for sure. But it's probably just changing goalposts to, you know, justify what they're doing at the time, which is always going to be dictated by budget. So not saying that it's lying and not saying that it's being mischievous. It's just going to be, well, it's going to hit a higher price or a deluxe pricing because of paint in this circumstance. In this one, it's accessories and plastic, and in this one, it's all three in one. And sometimes it might not correlate with the other, but you know that it's coming from a budgetary place anyway.
We know as well, their Battlestar, that there are clearly, if something is plastic and it can be part of the sculpt and mold, and maybe, or you know, a smaller weapon, that's maybe a little less expensive than, say, soft goods that have to be cut to size and then also applied to the figure, put around the head or whatever that may be. So that's more intricacy and handling work. So that can affect the cost. Things like battle droids is a good example where, yeah, it's an intricate sculpt because it's, you know, there's a lot of engineering to get those parts to work. And it was a beautifully designed figure, but as we've seen, they're going to keep using that battle droid sculpt. I mean, we've had
three or four
so far.
Three, I think, painted version, different versions, but they've released it on a card for a fourth time or whatever it was.
Yep. And it won't be the last. So we'll get plenty more of those. So hopefully that answers your question. Kenneth Curley Jr., Mr. 112 episode commenter said,
oh, we missed a bit. We missed one bit. Special edition change of CGI Jabba. That was the worst.
That's a good point. We did talk about that. What was your worst CGI change? I think they have improved it since the original.
They have. They've touched it since the movie, but you're cinema right. Version.
The first one with the stand on the tail, which they've removed since as well, I believe.
No. He still stands on the tail.
Does he make the noise?
A little bit. It's just it's all downplayed a little kind of thing.
Yeah. But you're right. That probably was one of the worst. God, the 90s, it's a different time. Kenneth Curley Jr. was saying, great show as always, enjoys these figures, the 6-inch Marvel Legends we covered, and he's always a big DC multiverse fan. Good on you, Kenny. And yes, it is a great time to be an action figure collector. McFarlane's definitely taken a lot of my money between Warhammer and loads of other lines they've got, so definitely a line to watch. Hayes WA says Mojo World was a must-have for me. He loved that era of uncanny X-Men comics, so that's where it really was from. As much as the early stories, the whole X-Babies thing was pretty humorous. Don't know what that was. Anyway, that was not the comedic artist that did the cover, Scott. Don't recall. Baker Scout 74.
There's more under there. There's a read more. There was the.
Oh, so there was.
And he could.
Fire Lord is a need too. I'm surprised he wasn't included with the HasLab Galactus as well. Cost there, I think. Hoping for Airwalker at some point as well. Don't know who that is. As for the live stream on Instagram, yeah, I think with a lot of people, it probably wasn't the most watched on Instagram. It's probably better on YouTube, but for most people. But he's barely on social. It would have been nice if they uploaded it on YouTube afterwards. Yeah, I think that would have made common sense to do that, but never mind. Breakerscape 74, for me, Jedi Rocks replacing Latinek was by far the number one crime the special edition changes were guilty of. Greedo shooting, yes. Replacing Boba Fett's original voice, Jason Wingreen, with Tim Morrison. I don't mind that one now myself, but yeah. Whenever I hear Latinek, I feel like I'm 9 years old again. Whenever I hear Jedi Rocks, I feel an episode of Roseanne is about to start. Very good, Baker Scouts.
Just to point out, they had 26,500 views of the Instagram broadcast.
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
Maybe not live, but what happens with Instagram is that people catch up with it because it then goes into the video section. You can always watch it, but 26,500 views.
You're the Instagram flag waver. I'm the YouTube flag waver. No, YouTube, Instagram. I don't know. Buy more. Deborah Bellas just says buy more. Okay.
I know Deb. I know Deb.
Okay, there you go. Well, we are anyway, regardless. Mark Karpf, his worst special edition change, Jabba the Hutt with Boba Fett Gunnigan's awful. Yeah, it's seeming to be the winner. It's a good one. Jason S, Ms. Marvel is out June 8th. She-Hulk is out August 17th.
I got it wrong.
You got it wrong, so even though we thought...
Okay, right, I still got it wrong.
We're back right again. So, okay, Ms. Marvel first, She-Hulk later on. There we go. Jason was enjoying Japan Spider-Man and Fire Lord, definitely a deep cut from the Marvel comic collecting days, and I was really hoping he would be a stretch goal. Well, there you go. You weren't the only one, and he enjoyed Instagram Live too as well. Worst special edition, you nailed it, honestly, the Death Star attack and the Cloud City escape are the only scenes that benefit. Yeah, that's true. Yeah. The improvements, that definitely, I think, made a difference. Running along the corridors, nicely being able to see the Slave One continue. That was, I did enjoy that one personally. That was good. Oh, you commented already. So there we go. Thank you for all your comments on episode 111. It was only 5 days ago, but thank you anyway, everybody who did. That was a very, very nice of you all. Bunch of reveals from Star Wars Celebration. Look, we'll go with the one that's first and we'll just share. It's already up for pre-order live. I'm sure we've already tweeted out or posted it or retweeted somebody. I think I did. But let us just share because it's already up, as you said, Matt, earlier on Darkseid. So there's a bunch of Reavas, Star Wars The Black Series, Reva 6-inch Vintage Collection, and a retro, which seems to be the flavor these days. Nice to see them getting released all at once, though. That was a nice touch. So this isn't really a spoiler because she's in the trailer and it doesn't tell you anything, but it's a fabulous looking figure. I thought it really captured it well.
I think Inquisitors are going to be awesome.
Screen?
Yeah, we can see it. Having Reva and then the other ones we'll talk about, but also having the second sister from Fallen Order.
Mm.
We're just going to be able to line up all these Inquisitors, and it's going to be awesome. Unlike something like the Knights of Ren, where we got like one of them, and then we just forgot about them. And
exactly, but it's
not wasting time on the Inquisitors, and it's great.
I think they really captured that face so well. She really stood out, I think, in the show for me. But yeah, as we were talking earlier on, just by saying nothing but got some grey, cool sculpted pants and boots and a soft goods cape. Looks very good indeed. And of course, her...
Yeah, the soft cape looks good too. Then we've gone the plastic option and it doesn't look... Looks good.
Really, really strong figure in the photography and the print. It's very nice indeed. Lots of subtle little touches you won't see in the black, even like the Imperial Cog. But the hair, the braids look beautiful. It's just, it's a gorgeous looking figure. Really, really nice. And it's bound to be very popular. And it is up for pre-order right now. So if you want to, as we said, get it in the 3.75 inch flavor, it's not really a great deal of difference. It's still a very good looking figure.
I can say that the cape is better on the 6 inch.
Yeah, the cape is definitely better than the 6 inch, but I think what is also noticeable for me is how matte and different the plastic is. Not you, Matt, the Matt with an E. I just felt it was quite a difference in the paint and the tone on the skin. So she's not got that kind of sweaty EVS plastic stuff going on. Just, yeah, for a 3.75 inch figure, I think it looks pretty damn good. And it's still one with a bubble on a great looking card and with that big wide Obi-Wan Kenobi. I thought they would stack it, but they didn't. But it looks good. Great looking figure. And again, if you're retro, I think it's literally the same card. I believe they used the same image, didn't they? Yes, they did. With the usual stuff and the horrific sticker. I love the they've just simplified it completely to just look totally retro. It really is with the old Darth Vader cape. So they're definitely sticking to the
and the beautiful all red lightsaber.
All red lightsaber screen.
Exactly. Return of the Jedi one.
It's kind of I see Mr. Stevie, as you know, has been sharing his love of retro and just going to town with the sand troopers and stuff, and I get it. I really see the desire to go back to that kind of simplicity, but yeah, just I can't fully go there after seeing realistic 6 inch figures. So
yeah, and the only time I'll do it now is for like really out of the box things. Like I thought you and I both got given one from Hasbro's, but the Boba Fett. Whether it's Book of Boba Fett or Mando Boba Fett, whichever one it was like that retro figure. It's kind of like, yeah. And other one I got too was I originally got the retro Mando figure. And it's like, yeah, okay, I'll do that one. But I can't go in there otherwise.
Starts getting a little bit too much, doesn't it? Anyway, there's a bunch of stuff, including the very first HasLab FX lightsaber reveal.
This is what I was going to talk about.
Okay.
No, it wasn't. This is one of the two things I was going to talk about.
Okay. Part one. We will share just this folder here, and we'll just share everything so you can see it. And let's tuck into the Force FX lightsaber. Yes, I know it's not 6 inches. You should see that on screen for you. You see?
Yeah.
Yep. Cool.
Yeah.
So just to go, it is the black series. I know it's not 6 inch, but we'll just have a quick flick through just that kind of stuff. So,
only because I want to say stuff about it as
go
well.
Go for it then. You know more about it than I do, and you care more about it than I do, because I don't really.
I'm coming from a not the best point of view. I'm just coming from the point of view of really, you fail on the Rancor and your next shot at the HasLab is something that potentially doesn't fund again. And you go, and why? Why couldn't you just release this as an FX lightsaber unless, and this is where I'm going to defend Hasbro potentially.
Okay.
Maybe it is Lucasfilm saying this is the next one you need to do and Hasbro going, we're not going to move, and I'm now making this up, 10,000 units of it. I don't know how many they make of the lightsabers. And then they've gone, you have to do it. And they're going, okay, well, we'll put it up as a HasLab and see if it gets 5,000 backers. And if it does, then it's paid for and we don't have to go backwards on it or get stuck with a run of 8,000 or 10,000, have 3,000 of them sitting around. But really, after the failed Rancor, and this is my point, this is a Black Series HasLab, not a vintage collection. It's a Black Series HasLab. And it's like, this is what we're going to do, a cosplay lightsaber for a show that's just coming out that, you know, is going to be double the price of the other ones. It's just, how many people are that invested in Kenobi and even Reva to jump? And I can tell you now, if you go to the actual HasLab page, not a lot of funded in 24 hours.
Last time
I looked, it was 400. And I'm like, we better hope. So it's 100 today after 400 yesterday. So we're not talking a lot. And it's just like, this is what I call bad decision making. But in defense of Hasbro, it could very well be Lucasfilm dictated. And we don't know. We don't know it, but it doesn't feel like it's the, hey, slam dunk, let's go for Reva's lightsaber at 5,000 and make this a real success. Because if this doesn't fund, it'll be the third HasLab not to fund after Cookie Monster and Black Series. It's just, you want a sure thing after a failure.
Yeah, and I think had this been a you know, Darth Maul or something like that, double bladed lightsaber, you could
have. Didn't they do that as a
it is a normal release. They've done several of them, but this, yeah, it would have just.
Give me a HasLab Stormtrooper outfit. You know what I mean?
It's too expensive for them. It's, but I mean, a lot of them.
Cosplaying.
$1,500. So.
Yeah, but they're making it out of plastic and mass producing it, not individually custom making it and whatever else. I'm just like, the helmet costs $190 or whatever. But I'm just. You want to go grand and you want to go big, or you want to, I don't know, in cosplay, like, I don't know, make a Boba Fett backpack. I don't know. You got the helmets now.
To me,
it should be for the figures. I'm just like, in the world that this isn't for a cosplay scenario for me, that standout or that demand to have demanded HasLab. It's no sail barge. It's no whatever Jin ship was called now that I can't remember that blew up. It's no Galactus. It's no, there's no legacy or history or nostalgia to it. This is an instant buy of a brand new thing. And we're going and fund it in 44 days. Within 44 days of the first time you see it on screen, fund it. There's no nostalgia attached to it. There's no, wouldn't a life-size Galactus be awesome or whatever it is. There's no nothing other than, oh, this new Inquisitor has a lightsaber. And dare I say it, they've made this when they don't even know what happens to Reva. We don't know whether Reva, and this is now pure speculation, no spoilers. We don't know whether she kicks it. We don't know whether she turns back from the dark side. We don't know whether she throws the lightsaber away in the fourth episode and picks up a green one. Like, we know nothing. And they wouldn't have known it a year and a half ago.
Yep.
Or a year ago. That's why I'm feeling it's a Lucasfilm decision, and it's no coincidence that all three Reva figures are launched with on the same day, which they've never done a retro Black Series and vintage collection on the same day. And her lightsaber is the, it feels like it's a Lucasfilm push on, because it's a really big gamble for Hasbro to go, we're going to gamble with an absolute new property, an absolute new item with no nostalgia and no must-have factor built up over 10, 20, 30, 40 years of a dream sail barge. And you can say the same thing about Mando's spaceship, but that came in bloody hot straight away.
I feel like if they'd done an AT-ST Walker and the 6-inch scale, huge as it may be, sold out.
100%. That's what I'm talking about.
A Death Star diorama piece, which clearly everybody wants, but they still can't do. Don't know why that's hard. You know, Mouse Droid is one of the giveaways. You know, a certain trooper is the next one. The Death Star room where Han and Luke are putting their feet up, and all the panels and something. I don't know, battles and. Give us the stuff that all the other toy companies are trying to substitute.
Give us a uniquely carded TK-421. Oh my God. which is exactly the same trooper that we've all been waiting for the last whatever, but give it a TK421 card. But yeah, this is the thing, when HasLab failed with Rancor, if you just read the comments, you would have found four or five surefire Black Series things like the AT-ST that people were wanting and stuff that would have been, let's just hit it with a home run. Why, my whole thing is, why burden Black Series with another tough slog? To me, it's, and I'm blaming Lucasfilm. I'm blaming Lucasfilm because it reeks of a bigger picture being dictated down, because I just don't see, even for everyone's criticisms, I don't see the Hasbro team going, we're going to kill it with Reaver's double lightsaber.
FX lightsabers do sell until the cows come home. They're big, big sellers. But the big, big sellers are well-established. Vader.
Obi-Wan. Anakin, Beta.
Obi-Wan. Blah, 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 blah. They're all the core character. You're not selling oodles and oodles of Kit Fistos.
And I don't even think I'd sell it. I don't think that the numbers on Rey's yellow lightsaber would sell strongly compared to Theo, and that's a $1.3 billion franchise, those ones. You know, regardless of anyone's take, I'm like, it doesn't have nostalgia. The yellow, like Rey's one, new property, new item, doesn't have nostalgia. And it's like, you know, I myself am tempted on the Obi-Wan lightsaber. I've never done a Hasbro Force FX one. I used to have one of the old ones beforehand, a Darth Vader one, years, like 15 years ago when they first did the light up things.
Yep.
But I myself am tempted on Obi-Wan's lightsaber.
Mm.
And that's the first one, unless I had another shot at Anakin's one. That's the first one. That and just the idea of going to Galaxy's Edge and making my own. But sure, there is no sense in Reaver's one a day after it's on TV for the first time on a 44-day campaign to fund it as a surefire. And HasLab should be a surefire. They shouldn't be, let's have more fail than succeed. I don't know.
Yeah, look, anyway, it's not 6-inch, so we'll, but let us hear your thoughts and comments on the first HasLab Black Series release since the Rancor. It's not great, is it? It doesn't feel great. Anyway, hey-ho. Another one we'll very, very quickly skim over is, I'm going to skim over, but we'll share it with you. One second, I will do it properly. I will just share everything, that way you can see it. It's another one of these multicolored, oh boy, you poor people that have to collect all these variants. I feel very sorry for you. Looks like they've almost essentially repackaged the one that came with the board game, resprayed it in the different colors, or recut it the different colors, and there you go, all your color combis, to give you the Snowspeeder prototype edition. So it really has the same figure. But just rainbowed. It's, you know, whatever. Okay, it is what it is. That is that. Let's see no more about that one. Let us know if you like that. 6-inch figure reveals on one of the panels today was Ayla Secura, looking very much like her great, great 3.75-inch figure from a wee, wee back. God knows why it took so long to get this. Surefire hit in the vintage collection, but finally, after 7 years, we get it in the Black Series.
You say seven, it's actually nine.
Is it nine?
We're 2022. No. 2022, 2013.
We've covered this before, and people were like, no, it's not, it's only 7 years. And I'm like, really?
Yeah, 2 years ago, it was 7 years. It's been 2 years.
Okay. nearly nine, we'll call it that, or nine. Ayla Secura is back. She looks exactly like the 3.75-inch figure I remember, and like the actress. Awesome. Pinless tech.
I like.
You like? Yes, I like too. Yeah. She looks great.
Is she available for order on June 1st? She is.
I will clarify that in just a moment. in the press release, which looks good. And they start working packaging too, so that will be a surefire hit, I think, for most people. So that's a great looking one. They revealed today, or just within the last 12 hours. Darth Maul was also revealed, looking rather good in his Clone Wars style, with a great looking head sculpt. Looks to be reused?
No, I think it's new.
Looks damn good anyway, regardless. Again, kind of almost fresh off the Vintage Collection style, because we got one of them not that long ago in this, but looks fab. Looks really good with these metallic legs.
So now we can finally get everyone. I say this with love for all my Black Series collector friends, shutting the hell up about Darth Maul's legs, because they're new. Because it's always like, oh, Darth Maul's legs. Oh, these old legs. These legs are 10 years old. These. Oh, the Dark Brothers got Darth Maul's legs. It's everything. Darth Maul's legs. It's like, oh, now he's got new legs.
New legs for all you Maul concerners out there. I like those legs. I thought the legs looked great on those figures. I picked the Dark Brother up again today, and I was like, don't do it. And I was like, hello legs. So they've done the job well.
That's good. It's I like it. I'm up for it.
Great pose, absolutely huge, which is a point actually for that FX lightsaber. Where would you put that thing? You better have a big wall, because it's
probably like 2 meters long.
Exactly, it's huge. Anyway, the Maul's looking good. Nothing much to say, it looks great. Got his Clone Wars legs going on, rocking it, looks great. Be a huge seller, it will just sell and sell. What else is next? Just another one. Another great pose. Really good.
Pretty sure these are all now posed by, including these shots now, is Matthew shooting the galaxy.
He's doing a good job. I think it was. He's
doing a great job posing these.
Yeah, perfect. Perfect pose.
Yeah.
Because some of them in the past were like, who's doing this?
My mom. Well, these are shots out of toy photography kind of thing. You can see how...
They've just got a bit of attitude about them and a bit of stance. We often used to just get the weapons just shoved in the hands.
Posed like a retro figure.
Correct. Exactly. It was pretty not great. So that was Darth Maul. We've got the fifth brother, another Inquisitor, to go. With his veiny face. Again, captured the facial likeness very, very well. Really, really good artwork. I'm not really seeing the cracks on the face. Don't call that, actually, on his face. But there you go. Got his little weirdy helmet on and blade from Obi-Wan Kenobi. Again, great poses. He looks good. Much more grey than the show. But yeah, looks good. Nice sculpting. Lots of red and belts and black. Cool boots, Inquisitor boots. Yeah, very good. Like it. And it fits on his back too. So that'll make a nice set. That's a great solid pose. Really good. Again, really good poses.
Just the fact that we're getting them all at the same time and
completing
teams.
Exactly.
None of this, you'll get the next Inquisitor in a year and a half's time is brilliant.
I agree. They do love a Biker Scout reuse, and this is getting up there with the Bobas. This has came out quite a few times, but it's back.
We've had a gaming greats of this as well, and now we're just calling it Riot with a shield.
Shield,
because we've had the Electro Staff Biker Scout in gaming greats from Fallen Order before.
That's correct. Yes, we have. So, yeah, they get to reuse that mold again. Let's hope it's not got that really terrible red wire around the back. In fact, I think it has on the super dodgy wire that on the Vintage Collection version, if you bent it too far, it would snap. But, Riot Shield from the game. My God, this is from Jedi Survivor, the new game.
Well, there you go.
Ah, okay. Not Jedi.
Same.
Yeah. I don't know whether that's true or not. I mean, it feels a bit weird. Yep, it's got a silly red cord, and I bet they've made it too tight. Hopefully not. So yeah, biker scout with belt, with braces, I should say, and yeah. It was always a good mold. It was never really terrible. It's getting a bit tired in parts, but still looks kind of good. With shield. Yeah, that's rocking it. I like it. Can't say no to a biker scout personally. Repaint it, repay it, respray it, do what you want. I'm just like, yeah, I kind of like it. Looking good with these little shields. Yeah. Not much more to say about them. Gaming great, so there'll be GameStop / EB Games / Zing / what was it
again? It'll be also Zavi and Star Action probably.
So even though they can't tell us that, because that's top secret, that would somebody would have to die if they told us that. But yeah, it will be. Grand Inquisitor, another 6-inch Inquisitor figure. Yeah, looking good. And the actor revealed this on his Instagram earlier on. Won't see any more about his character right now, but yeah, that looks good. They seem to have got quite a different colour on the figure as opposed to the show. It seems to be slightly different, more kind of green than kind of whitey, creamy colours. But still,
yeah, it's kind of somewhere between the cartoon version and the TV show.
But he's looking good. Not showing his fugly teeth, thankfully.
Do we see his teeth in the show, or is it kind of...
You do, briefly. They're the really weird kind of rabbity, weird...
Inverted, yeah. Inverted
teeth, yeah, which doesn't really make sense, but I mean... yeah, he did have a very large head in the show. I saw a lot of criticism about that, but... Looks great. I figure they've really scanned that face in, and again, the pose there really does help sell this. So again, good job shooting the galaxy. Your pose really brings it into play. Nice. Very, very nice. You would never have got that back in the day from Hasbro's pose.
No.
Just wouldn't have happened. So real action poses. A nice cape inside there too. Yeah, this will make a great set, the three of them together. I'm sure there's part swapping in some areas for some of them, which will help them get things going. But yeah, that looks nice. Nice indeed. That's a nice pose too. Great sculpt, great paint, great effects. Timed for the release of the show. Perfecto. Absolutely perfect.
And it's just it just is. It's this return to quality mainline figures, which is what I've been begging for however many months. And I get it, it's new content and everything else, but it is the mainline figures that we keep saying are incredible. And then there's some nice exclusives and whatever else out there, but they've become such shitty reuse stuff and not the most creatively thought out reuse, but the mainline stuff is everything I still love about the Black Series, from the two ways we've seen.
Oh,
and this stuff at the moment is, it's fresh, and it's, again, better brownie decisions
points. Huge brownie points. They've just
best decisions being made by putting these Inquisitors all out together and not falling into that Knights of Ren trap of, oh, we'll do some now and then we'll do something. It's like, we're going to forget about it next year and you're going to move on from it next year, and you're not going to... Black Series has never proven itself to be Black Marvel Legends, which says, let's go back and finish something.
Mm.
It's kind of like, if we move on, we've moved on.
Yeah.
So by all means, keep pumping them out, please. Pump out all the Kenobi figures. Because do you know what was not here today? One figure from the Book of Boba Fett. That show that has had two figures that were technically from The Mandalorian.
Mm-hmm.
So there's no Jennifer Beals kind of Twi'lek. There's no
Wouldn't have
Boba Fett. There's no Boba Fett from Boba Fett. Mm. We've got the throne room from the last scene of Mando season 2, but we have no Boba Fett, Boba Fett from Book of Boba Fett. Vintage Collection's got it.
To be
fair. Where he doesn't have the...
Yeah.
He's got the pants and not the... no remnants of the Tusken Raider outfit.
Sure.
And all that stuff, which is all Mando stuff. We still don't have that Boba Fett. Mm. Where, again, Vintage does. They've got both versions.
Yep.
I love Obi-Wan. I love that we're nailing it and we're putting all these things out. But today was a distinct absence of, like, even, oh, by the way, you're also going to get your Boba Fett from the show 3 months ago.
That may be, okay, that won't be Wednesday, but yeah, you're right. It's a very much, I kind of don't blame them with the last, personally, my personal opinion, don't be freak out, but the last Star Wars movie in theaters, the
Rise of Skywalker.
I can't even remember the bloody name. There you go. That shows you how much I didn't really care for the film. I couldn't even remember the name of it offhand. They really went super light on the figures, and I felt they just wanted it to be over. And I felt the poison it wasn't selling. Anyway, and you're right, there seems to be a limit on how many figures they can do, whether production runs capability, I don't know, but it's anyway, most of these figures, we should add, and we mentioned earlier on, available for pre-order 1 June. So what's that? That's in Monday. Is that Monday?
No. 29th, 30th. Wednesday. It must be Wednesday. Obi-Wan Wednesday. There we go.
There you go. Wednesday, the 1st of June, at all good toy stores. So BBTS, Dorksey Toys, and whatever you are in your countries, you can go and buy it. Local stores in Australia and New Zealand and UK, you'll be able to get most of this stuff pretty much everywhere. Because it's TV supported, I think that helps it too. The only one which was exclusive was the Scout Trooper, the Jedi Survivor, not Jedi Fallen Order, even though it was in Jedi Fallen Order. So I guess we're getting that again in Jedi Survivor. I don't understand. Anyway, moving forward. So there was also another figure for another Inquisitor. Let me just share on screen.
It's Sister?
Yeah, the fourth Sister.
Fourth.
So this is digital render only, but again, it's going to make a great team, the four of them. Kind of Twi'lek-ish, like, I think, Twi'lek? Can't really tell with...
So that's a render, but they did have one on display.
Right.
On the stand.
Cool. Have you got a photo of that? We'll get back to
you. I think I've got a shot of it on my page, yeah.
Awesome. Sweet. Even as a digital render, looks good. You can really see the sculpt there. Looking good. Yeah, she's nice. Very nice indeed. I think that there's only two shots. Yep. All of her. So yeah, won't be the last Inquisitor we will see in the Kenobi show for sure. But there you go, that's another one that was revealed. Another one which was a little leaked quite heavily and is a bit of a pain in the buttocks to get. What the hell was going on with this one?
Okay, so this is my other rant.
Yes. So QR codes venture in this, but what did you have to do? You had to go to the booth?
You have to go to the booth. You have to get your QR code. And then at a later date, in a month or a couple of months' time, whatever, you can redeem your unique QR code on Hasbro Pulse. And my point being is, again, we're not there. It doesn't matter. It doesn't apply to us, whatever it is. Mm-hmm. But going to a con, let's just say... And we know he's not there this time, but he goes to almost all of them. Jesse flies from Adelaide to Anaheim to go to the convention. And one of the things he gets as a attendee of the convention is the right to buy the exclusive. And here they're going, and you've got that right by being here because here's your QR code. He now comes back to Australia and he can't redeem that QR code because Pulse is only available in four territories. So again, it's this ignoring of international fans. And it's, again, it's definitely changing goalposts, because years ago it's like, why can't we all get a bloody whatever it is? It's like, well, it's a con exclusive. It's made as a con exclusive. It's for those who attend the con. You go, okay, if that's the rule, sure. Now you've got people who are attending the con, and it's like, who attend the con, get the code, and then live in one of four countries because it's a pulse driver or whatever it is.
It is,
or we didn't have them ready or whatever it is. It's just like, it is such bad fan service. And it's incredibly disappointing for somebody in Australia. And just to put it into perspective for American viewers and everything else, whether it's a $2,000 flight over, and whether it's then your accommodation at $300, $400 a night, and whatever it is, and you go, yeah, that's all fine. Add another 30% onto all that, because that's the exchange rate for an Australian to fly over. So your $300 room is actually $450 a night, or whatever it is. Your registration isn't just your registration, it's your registration plus 30%.
Sure.
Everything is this thing. And the one little thing you got was the right, like when you went to Celebration, to buy your Luke Skywalker 40th anniversary shiny whatever. Thank you very much for my one. But that was your thing as a Pulse exclusive, as a con exclusive. There's 10,000 of them. And if you're there and you line up and you've got the opportunity and you're one of the people attending Star Wars con and you're a Black Series fan, you get that benefit, because there's another 30, 40, 50,000 people who aren't interested in Black Series, and they're going for their pins or their whatever else, their posters or whatever they're doing. Now it's like, oh, you get here and nah.
But you're talking about, Kel, you've covered this to death, but we're talking about
a
company who, in press releases to us and people all across the world, can't even tell you any other countries it's available in outside the US.
I know. But and this is now a con thing, and it's just,
I know that, but the
spoon fed it for years. Con people get con exclusives, and it's like, no, Hasbro Pulse people at the cons get the con exclusive now.
Oh, look, Pulse, don't get me started on that. I personally disagree with the whole philosophy of it, because it shafts everybody else. And one breath, it's like available to most participating retailers, but the plugging on Pulse, we know, is like, you know, weirdly, oddly, just not right. But never mind, that's up to them, it's their toys. But the fact that they can't see that gaming greats figure behind you when it was launched, it's also available at such and such and such and such. That to me just staggers beyond belief why you wouldn't see where things are available to buy. It's completely ignoring. No, it's not available anywhere. We're not even going to talk about it. We won't even mention it. It's something's weird about that. It's very strange why wouldn't you tell your audience where the figures are available? Anyway, if you're lucky enough to get the QR code, you too can buy for the fourth time the same figure that you've got, which came out the first time in slightly different blue, slightly different paint, but you get a John Favreau shiny, sweaty head.
Slightly less weathering, i.e. no weathering.
There's a little.
I had a look at mine today.
You're right, there's a lot less than the previous one.
I'm assuming it's not a removable helmet. I'm assuming it is a...
swap out.
Pop it on, pop it off, because...
Yeah, I would agree. I would absolutely agree. I can't see it being different. It does show in the box. Yeah, it doesn't really tell you, does it, I guess? So
no, because it's got a face. It's got a neck down, head up.
Yep. So, you know, had this never been available before now, I think we're all a bit mad at trying to get this figure, but beautiful box. They've done it the same as before many years, this kind of continual theme, which is lovely. It's really nice when they continue a theme. It is this huge double box, but so be it. But yeah, there you go. You get the QR code, you get to yet to buy it. So
if you're in Germany, UK, Canada, or America.
Correct. Correct. So it's a little bit... let us know what you think. Leave a note in the comments below. Next, there's a figure I don't think anybody really, really wanted. But we're getting it nonetheless, which is Grief Karga makes, I think, fourth or fifth reoccurrence in the Black Series line.
Depends if you count the double pack in his first appearance.
That's true, 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 true. Not anything against Grief Karga or the Arctic Curl at all, but...
I'm absolutely fine with this figure if we just didn't get the awful re-release of the Critic Collection. If it wasn't double-packed and struggling. Like, I mean, I like this appearance. I like this figure. I'm down with it to be like a season one, season two thing and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. But they've just milked that first figure too many times.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, I don't know. Yeah, it comes back to my Critic Collection stuff, which we don't need to talk about.
It's evident that Hasbro have offered the Credit Collection Grief. So, yeah, you're right. They've made this so many times, but the retail, the exclusive that they gave to us at Best Buy in the US and literally everybody else they say the US, no one's buying this damn thing. I don't know.
It's just, look. Again, and they've got new sculpts on this. They've got new pieces on this.
Sure.
And this is where I keep coming back to, hey, do you know what else was really cool in Mando that you can reuse for Return of the Jedi? Your squid men and your prune faces and whoever else from the Bo-Katan episode on the ship. If you're going to put new tooling stuff in there, just make the world a little bit broader. Challenge us a little.
Yeah. It's just not a huge seller. It's just not.
Do you know who else would have been, who would have been more welcome at this point in time and save this one for later or skip thing?
Mr. Threester.
Removable helmet, taking Axe Wolves or whatever his name is.
Axe Wolves, but also there's a three-stripe variant. I think there's a one-stripe variant. Turn the freaking thing out again. Nope.
But just make Axe out of this and you take the helmet off and give him his head and... reuse potentially 100% or 99%, depending on the head, of everything else. Like, I mean, yeah. It's just begging there. It's, let me help you make money, Hasbro. Let me be your character selection guy.
I think another one that just astounded me, I think you reviewed it, but the US only. Again, they never give this to any other retailer outside the US. Which
where did your one come from? Mine hasn't arrived yet.
Zavi made it available to the UK market, but apart from the US, the Walmart Clone Wars Arc Trooper versions, the one that also had Grievous and
Mace Windu. Have you got your Mace yet?
No, I think I cancelled it.
Okay.
Yeah, cancelled it. I mean, just kind of instead of Grief, it's a figure they've done before, but the main line, this is what we're talking about before as well, how the main line kind of gets shafted. They flood the channel with Grief Kargas, and yet figures like this are exclusive. And then they also had the goddamn audacity to have a face flesh-coloured helmet or head underneath this, but glued it to the helmet.
So it's not even the white head like there is underneath.
It's not a white head. It is a
painted, this is a blue head, actually.
It is a flesh head. It's really hard to see. You can just see the flesh.
Oh, yeah, I can see it. Yep.
Why? Why would you do this? Why would you do this? I can only think it's a cost exercise that Tim Morrison is quite rightly saying, you owe me more money.
It can't be.
Why?
Because TVC keep doing it. TVC have the removable helmets with his head on it, and I think he's signed his likeness away and doesn't get paid too much more for different figures using his head.
Yeah, probably.
But it's this TVC Black Series thing of why can TVC
troopers
have a removable helmet and Black Series can't? I don't know.
Understand what they're doing. But hey, let's have another grief cargo. Just doesn't make sense.
Just make sure we double pack him.
Yeah. What is going on? Free consulting Hasbro available here on the Sixth Sense Show. We'll tell you. Now I know they have sales data, and I'm only being facetious, and I'm, you know, we're being picky and we're poking fun at this.
I don't know if they've got the sales data that backs the decisions they're making on certain things.
Or maybe it's someone sitting the Lucasfilm going, no, you're not doing that.
100%. This is what I was talking about, the Hasbro Pulse Reaver thing, which is what I'm talking about. Is like, if you want to make money, there's other decisions to be made. And this is where I'll defend Hasbro, because it just feels like these decisions are being made above them. And as I've said before, it feels like, I don't think Lucasfilm's got worse in the last 3 years or 4 years than what they were 7 years ago and et cetera and stuff. If I was to, in theory, fault Hasbro team for anything, it's maybe not either articulating, justifying, or fighting a position, pushing back, just like the overlords are talking, we're going to do what they say, sure, as opposed to potentially maybe we had a different experience under the different regime, because there's more dialogue about, that sounds good, but what about this? And we've done the numbers on this and this, and how about this? It just feels like...
nobody knows what they're doing.
I feel like there's a hand coming down from Lucasfilm and not much pushback. Like, they say, we do. You want a Reaver one? We're going to go Reaver on HasLab and... whatever. You want another grief cargo? I guess we're doing another grief cargo. But I just feel like, I don't know. Rah.
I
can talk about this every week.
I kind of yearn for the Daryl DePriest days, where way back in the 3.75 inch when the Clone Wars started, boy, did we get clones. Boy, did we get clones. And they went deep. They gave us fictitious, not even seen on screen, Mace Windu clones. They gave us Kit Fisto. They just went deep. And now
you could even say now they're giving us clones, but they're giving them as exclusives.
As exclusives, and they can't be given by anyone. They're not allowing the helmets to be removable.
Yeah, it's
what?
Really? Like, I mean, if it was about selling units and making money, just in theory, and this kind of relates back to that other question from the beginning of it, is you are reusing existing molds, mm-hmm, and all you're doing is repainting them. Mm-hmm. So that's an inexpensive figure to start with. So it's not really the whole exclusives, we couldn't make them without these partners, because you're starting from a very cheap base. It's cheaper to make those clones that are all exclusives than it is to make the Grief Karga. Grief Karga should be the Walgreens exclusive. The 187th Battalion Mace Windu should be a mainline and or fan channel thing, where it's not like Walgreens wants to buy 10,000 of them. It's like, oh yeah, we could make 30 or 40,000 of these clone troopers. And guess what? We could also make 30 or 40,000 of these 13th Battalion clone troopers. And we could make 30 or 40,000 of these 332 Battalion clone troopers, mm-hmm, all using exactly the same mold, different paint application. So the only budgetary difference is, does brown paint cost more than yellow paint? And how much yellow paint do we need from the 13th to the 332nd Battalion on the different arrow sizes? Like, they are budget makers, but it's totally the budget makers that are getting 10,000 exclusive order for Walgreens, or 20,000, whatever it is, but not everywhere around the world in this market. It's just like, come on, guys, this is not making sense. Grief Karga in Mando season 2 is the perfect example of the exclusive. It's a nice to have, not a must have.
Correct.
Take it from Marvel, that aside from the fact that they decided to go with bloody Jigsaw and Zemo, but take it from Marvel last year, Quasar, he's nice to have for those who want him, not a must have for everybody. That's an exclusive. That's an exclusive.
We talked about this before, and I said, I think we said, or a clone fan here was saying, I mean, like, give to the fan channels, give it the clone collection. Now all you need to do is just make clones, just give them clones every month, different paint, different blaster, blast effect, something. Just reuse the same goddamn thing. We will all buy them because there's so many people buy clones.
Or and that's the that's the point. It's like, you know, if you had them out to fan channels or in mainlines or whatever, and it was, I'm making the number up now, but let's call it 30,000.
Sure.
There's very few people who go, I want my 332nd battalion and I want my 13th battalion, but I don't want my 187th battalion. Everyone tends to be.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
When it comes to troopers, army builders, like literally, they are the army. Mm-hmm. And you build them.
Look, in between the big three of BBTS, Strokeside, and EE, who really are the biggest, probably, well, they're US-based, but they're more global shipping. Well, forget EE, global shipping. But at least those other two, they could make them. And they've done it before with Vintage Collection, but not with Six Inch. It's such a weird...
Look, again, it's the same thing. Again, we're at another con, and Vintage Collection now reveals the Hoth Trooper. Hasbro Pulse exclusive, four different heads with a sergeant in there or a commander or whatever it is, ranked, whatever. And it's like, yeah, let's continue to army build Vintage and let's not do shit. We don't even have a Hoth Trooper. Well, we have a Hoth Trooper, but we don't have this version of it, which is the kind of Luke puffy beige jacket. Hoth thing.
Yep.
Like,
yep.
No, we've got no variety. It's just like, come on, guys. And again, I said it today on one of my posts and people were like doing the thing. I ain't hanging shit on TVC. And I don't give a shit if everyone wants to come at me and go, oh, but TVC was in the wilderness while Black Series got all the attention and everything else. It's like, we've heard it before, but Black Series, without Black Series, your TVC would have never have come back. Did the heavy lifting for 5 years. And this is not about one versus the other. This is about Marvel Legends, MCU, and comics coexisting and not getting shafted for, oh, we're really into MCU at the moment, so the comic figures are getting ignored, or we're really putting the effort into MCU, so they're getting all the removable helmets and comics are getting minimal whatever, one set of hands. It's TVC and Black Series is MCU and comic in Marvel. They can coexist and they can both kick ass. It doesn't have to be priority of one over the other. There's no war, and there should be no war between, you know, it should be, why not want the best for all the Star Wars lines? In this, forgetting, I know we talk about the Chewbacca masks and stuff, but in the collector world, like with Marvel Legends, it's like, no, MCU, comics, Black Series, TVC.
Yep.
It's one line. It's one collector.
Sure.
Treat everyone with bloody respect and treat the lines with respect.
Just very questionable choices. And look, for all we know, Grief Karga, I mean, you'd think they look at sales data and must be saying, hey, Grief Karga's selling tons. You know, let's do another one. But it doesn't really look that way for what we can see after
Mark. Not based on the double packing that Grief Karga went through on the first one.
That's for sure. Let's move on. We've got another one, Obi-Wan Kenobi and Darth Vader, which was an unusual reveal, but kind of looks as if they're kicking off a concept art collection, which is
nice. The Ralph McQuarrie collection.
Nice little logo down there.
It comes with an unfortunate.
What's the unfortunate?
Of course, it's exclusive to Disney Shop.
Oh, yeah, that's right, that's right. Well, look, I suspect there will be single releases of these down the line at some point, but they're not going to let this Vader go. Notice how it's in the blue colour there, but I suspect you'll get a prototype Vader or something, or a Macquarie Vader at one point. Yeah. And that'll be a re, or that is a reused Obi-Wan body.
Maybe the arms.
Yeah.
But it's a new torso. Maybe the arms and the lower cape.
It looks very much like a reused Vader apart from the helmet. So anyway, yeah, you can tell it is the artwork. There's nothing on the panel. There's lots of buttons on the panel. So they're reusing the... See, that stuff drives me bonkers. It's like, if you're going to do it, do it. But they reused... I understand why. I highly suspect you'll get another version of this at some point, but maybe I'm wrong. Let us know what you think.
I think it's a step in the right direction, but it's also, it does open the door for what we've asked before and then get given. It's all realistic in Black Series. It's like, you could do a Clone Wars figure with an animated Obi-Wan head. We can step away from the it's all realistic Black Series now, because this is that first step into that broader world, because they're going to start, well, there's still plenty of characters they can do, because they obviously don't want to do a Lobot. They're going to start running out of things to do, that they have to find something special, and this is the kind of path they're going. I think it's cool. Like, I mean, if this was available on the fan channels, I would have I'd be grabbing one. I just would. But again, I can live without it.
Yeah, I've never been a huge Vader fan anyway. I think he's a whiny git. But that's an Obi-Wan body, man. That is an Obi-Wan body. That's which is fine. Again, whatever. If you want it, you like it. That's good for you. But
because you know, we might get a concept Stormtrooper. We might get a concept.
Sure.
Chewbacca using the Zeb head.
The thing is that the concept Stormtrooper is quite radically different from the regular Stormtrooper. And if they just slap a different helmet on and a
shield. They're different legs for Obi-Wan.
They'll be using some of these. That's his leg.
Yeah.
Hey-ho, look, it's you're getting a rough Macquarie Vader in 6-inch, but it feels a shame when the 3.75-inch managed to get a version that was pretty spot on accurate. Why the 6-inch lane just doesn't get that sculpting love there? I think for that is a bit annoying. But hey-ho, a Disney Parks exclusive, as you said. I think that's also available 1 June or from some point on. But let us know what you think of this. Essential, not essential, good, bad. Let us know what you think. Concept art edition. We've got a few more to go. One of these is the Lola two-pack figure. That's from the Bounty Collection. Even though it's not 6-inch at all, but a quick look at that. Just the little, I really feel this was product placement myself. And just not great. But again, for younger kids, they'll probably love it. 3.75-inch got some love. They got, this really annoyed me. they got a little, basically a kind of container, be a kind of hall of armor, if you will, for the Dark Trooper, which allows you to build a really nice set. I mean, again, we're paying so much more for the deluxe.
We don't like dioramas, Fly Guy.
Oh, really?
We don't like dioramas. 6-inch people don't. They're not into dioramas or pieces.
Look at it. Oh my God. It's just like, what? Oh, jeez, man. I mean, it's just, this just keeps going on. It just keeps getting worse. Where does the love in 6-inch? It's gone. But thanks to Emily. Is it Emily?
Emily, yeah.
From the Hasbro team. You're killing it, Emily. If this is you, which I think it was, probably. I don't know. Don't know what it is. Cheap or something. They can manage to do it. But, and blast effects too. Wow. And swap out hands. Jeez, this is just... It's kind of a slap in the face for 6-inch, isn't it?
I've been saying it for about 15, 20 shows now.
I know.
And it's not about one or the other. It's actually about why can't both be...
I know. It's really quite depressing, actually, the more we go through this. Anyway, let's get to the next one. Jedi Gaming Greats. They get a 3.75-inch Survivor multi-pack. Three packs. So let's look at that. So a 3.75 K2SO with added kind of a backpack on them there.
I don't remember the game that this is meant to be from. Maybe it's from the new one. I don't know. Where they've got a staff. I just remember the droid beating up Cal Kestis, but not with a weapon.
See, what's very odd is I don't recall the Magna droid, as this is called, being re-released in the Vintage Collection recently. But they're, which they could have, but they're quick to slap it out as a Jedi Survivor multi-pack. I guess this is going to be in the
game. Guess it's in the game.
Really?
It's not in Fallen Order.
Yeah, we had this in, oh no, in Riot Trooper. We had it. Oh God, I mean, the previous version's still not selling particularly well, I thought, but. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, fair enough. You're getting the same figure, but this time with a shield. Okay.
Oh, do you know, there's one thing, we'll do it when I get to my page, actually.
Okay, three figures. Okay, fair enough, Hasbro.
Wasn't there also a bloody, let's see.
This was the Obi-Wan Kenobi 3.75. Noticeable there was in the package shot, we get the Lolas included with him.
And included with the Black Series one, they had photos of Lolas.
That was the figure that was omitted. Quite why he's got Lola, I guess. Maybe Lola is, maybe plays into it later on for him. Yeah, look, you know, for a vintage figure, not too bad. Doesn't say. That's supposed to be a real figure, but it's very digitally rendered. But anyway, maybe it's just really sharp and it's a good quality pick. But yeah, like not bad. 4-inch figure, pretty good. He's using a blaster, how uncivilized. Then I think near the end was another 3.75, which hasn't been revealed in the show yet, I think. This is Antok Medic's droid to go with his vintage figure and vintage vehicle. Although a lot of
which we never saw was red.
Which was, I think, cancelled in a large amount for both the 6-inch and the 3.75. No, the 3.75 was with the vehicle. The 6-inch got cancelled heavily. But there you go. Yeah, it looked great. Beautiful.
Mine got cancelled.
Did it? There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah, they really screwed up on that one. And there we go with the Hoth Trooper pack. So yes, all the colours. All the flavors looking good. Nice bit of variety for your troop building. I think there's some more. Yeah, this is the more shots there too. With Tash, without Tash, goatee beard, full beard, no beard. It's like it's the boy band. It's the Hoth Rebel Bad Boys. So yeah, a good way to get army builders and a very good way of. Getting them out there, and again, Pulse exclusive. And I think that was it, but let's go and look at your toy photography as well. But have you got that on your main page?
Yeah, go onto my main page because there's the other thing, which is the pipeline reveals.
Cool. So instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries is Matt's page, if you weren't aware, but we'll run through. Yes, some pics will look the same as we've just covered, but we'll still go through them. Let's have a fly through. So there's the actor who...
Rupert Friend.
Grand Inquisitor. Yes, Rupert Friend. Pretty good. There is an in-hand shot of the fourth sister. So they've got a prototype on the show. Just flip through this way. Grand Inquisitor in the flesh. I love how they always have stands.
Yeah.
I've always said this. They always have stands in their figures, but they can't give us these stands.
Can't even put them on Hasbro Pulse.
Yep. Sacrilege, no. Can't tell you where to buy figures, but I also can't give you that. So that was a tease for
Black Series being, yeah, so game, I guess, gaming greats. Darth Malak and Distiller Shan. Yep.
Yep, that'll be good. They also will be GameStop because they're or slash
Zing.
Zing, thank you, EB Games, etc. It's the goal. Yeah. Kill Secure on the day. Yep. Grief Cargo. I would have loved to have the audience reaction. We don't need more Grief Cargo. Ah, dear, oh dear, oh dear. I'm guessing they thought Lando needed company in the peg. Another Grief Cargo. Not this guy again. Shelf Warmer. Oh my goodness. Yeah, you're not getting a Cara Dune, that's for sure. She
didn't change her appearance, did she, anyway?
Yeah. Yep, we talked about Maul. Poster. That was the empty booths before they filled them up. They always do that show.
Yep.
The band's all here. Nearly. Looking good.
One short still, at least.
One short still, yeah, exactly. Skilling Crew, that was the other reveal from the day with Jude Law. Kind of Ocean's 11 criminal bunch thing, I think it was. Yep.
John Don't Williams. Know, yeah.
Where did we get to? Where did we get to? The band, Andor trailer, the John Favreau trooper in the flesh, looking less sweaty, which is good. The Leia trooper in hand, I think we've seen, yeah, we have seen troops on before, of course we have. The Fett, which is coming soon, the Sev, which is coming soon, the other arrow shooting
Night Brother.
Hey, brother. More of the squad. That's the other one as well. The other droid from the security droid, the rebel droid. Looking very good indeed. Security droid.
Look, call it crazy nostalgia, but it's so strange again to be posting booth shots.
True after COVID and everything else.
It's been 2 years, two plus years, whatever it is, and I was kind of like, no, I'm going to do it, even though I've seen these figures. It's just nice to see them on shelf again. And doesn't photograph too well, the Dark Trooper.
No,
it's in my opinion.
Poopy Trooper and Banana Trooper. Then we're into toy photography. That's a fab shot of Hunter.
Yeah,
just a real nice micro shot, wham bam click photography. What was on display was just the reveal of the
Reaver.
There's the Favreau trooper, looks good. Where's Wally? And I think the last time we did the show, we covered that we went overdose on the Death Watch Mandalorian, but he's still cool. And a really nice Republic Commander trooper there, too. With the blue visor. Why couldn't they do the blue visor? Oh my god. Anyway. Good. Oh, we're back to that one already. To the last show, which I think
we've It's only 5 days.
It's only 5 days, that's true. Let's get a look at your Marvel Legends page. 6-inch Legends.
Yep.
What's going on there? That's a nice shot of Jigsaw and Kingpin. Looking very nice in the white suits.
Talk about boy bands.
I know, talk about boy bands. Yeah, that's really cool. Nice job, Mr. Lee. Nice Spider-Man reference there too. Do you like your 80th Hulk? Are you liking him?
No,
I'm not liking him either, actually. I just did a review the other day. I just wish they'd put the Red Hulk head on the 80th body. It just worked. But
One of the Farouche guys, I think, I bent my man thing, repainted the red head as green, and it looks incredible.
I would do that.
Well, that's actually, it's half of the Compound Hulk. If you look at the green half of the Compound, that's the Hulk I want. I want the green Hulk, that lime green, those purple pants, with the red Hulk face painted all green. Hasbro, right now, Marvel Legends team, if you're watching this Star Wars episode, you have the sculpt there. You have 50% of the paint done. You just need to complete the other 50%, and I'll buy it again.
And also, don't make the bloody red Hulk Target exclusive. It's like so hard to get hold of.
Took us 2 years.
I know, but it wasn't that, but it's so many people couldn't get it. So many people couldn't get it. It was a really, really low run.
But you and I got it when it came back for a third time mystery release on the shelves unannounced. It was like, oh, they've turned up again, and we got a friend to grab it.
Yeah.
But it was like, that was like a year and a half after a release. It's like, when does that ever happen? But it was just impossible.
Totally. And it was only last week we did the show, but there's one more pick. Nice goblin pick there. Norman has been very naughty. Alpha Tango. So yeah, lots and lots of cool toy photography on Sixth Sense Legends, but part Matt's stuff, which is all under Toy Tribe. And of course, the page earlier on we were on was Instagram.com. And it doesn't seem to want to go back. There we go. Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries. What did we miss? Anything we didn't cover? I think we covered most of
it. I think that's about it.
For now.
Yeah, there might be something turn up before we do the next show. There's going to be an Obi-Wan Wednesday again. I'd like to see, and I'm going to say it now because it's in the trailers and stuff, but I would like to see a Joel Edgerton Lars.
I'd buy that. I'd buy that.
And hopefully he's still got a part to play, and I'm sure he does, but I'd like to see that figure.
T-16 Skyhopper would be a nice accessory.
Yeah. I don't think much else at the moment. Did anything else happen in the Marvel world? No. There was the Morph X-Men, or did we do that in the last episode? We did that in the last episode.
Did we? It's basically the Cyclops
with pinless Cyclops with a new head,
and Hasbro Pulse really hasn't shown much more. It's Transformers Morph.
I think there's been more pictures, and we just dealt with the box last time, but that's fine. People can look it up, it's on our pages.
Exactly. So there's not a great deal else at the moment as yet. I'm just having a quick flick through channels and other stuff to see if there's any more going on there.
Oh, what we can do, because I'm just in the mood to let people know. I'm just going to check that it's still there. Let's go to Dorkside for a sec.
Bring that up on screen.
For anyone outside of Pulse territories looking for their Han Solo Power of the Force figure.
Yeah, good call. That's right. If there's still any left.
Yeah, they're still there.
There we go. Yeah, they've been buying a lot of exclusives. A lot of stores have been getting exclusives. G.I. Joe, BBTS, etc. But Star Wars, there was a few here. The Han Solo Power of the Force, slightly different painted head Han.
So it's photo. It's got the photo reel treatment on it.
Which is a nice little addition. Same figure. Got all the bits, which is nice. I think they gave all the bits.
Most of the bits. It's got one of the bits. Doesn't have the extra hands, but it's got the Stormtrooper belt.
That's so lame to not include the extra hands. God damn it, Hasbro. It's like such petty stuff like that. It just pisses me off. Anyway, so be it. But yeah, that's available. Yep, you're right. And there is also a bunch of other stuff as well. There was the formerly Walmart vintage collection Leah Endor. There was
Just also, this is new since we've last spoken. Dorkside in Marvel Legends also has for pre-order the Invisible Woman and the Johnny Storm
Goddamn, didn't know that.
Non-torch for pre-order.
Oh, cool.
They're just turned up in the last couple of days, if not today.
Sweet. So yeah, if you miss those exclusives, you get a chance to buy it again. That's really cool. This is the way it should be, is the exclusive should eventually come to Fan Channel so we can finally buy the damn things.
Yeah. Exclusive should be first dibs, not all dibs.
Correct. And that makes much more sense for Hasbro because it gives them more chance to sell products. So
I do like this Johnny Storm.
Yeah, feeling it myself, but yeah, they kind of, the hair doesn't. I don't know. Still, it's a nice chance to get another exclusive. Yeah, there's a bunch of stuff up there. There's loads and loads of vintage, I think, from memory as well. Other ones, there was the
Zemo and the Quasar, which we spoke about last time. And a whole heap of vintage, like Yoda and all that stuff.
Yeah, the Target exclusive droids and the Death Star droid was an exclusive as well. This was an exclusive.
I think this is actually just a ongoing sign of Hasbro getting, as we've said before, getting burnt by their other retailers. And it's like, treat your fan channels first and then go to the other retailers.
Sell more of your stuff, that's for sure. Yes, there we go. Again, vintage figures with removable helmets. So, but yeah, 6-inch, nah. Let's shaft them. Oh, God. It's the fact that it's a flesh-colored helmet underneath the goddamn helmet. It's like, really? Oh, it's so annoying.
What's going to be worse if you pop it off and find out that the eyes are painted as well and the hair's
painted? It's like maybe perfect,
I don't think they have either. I'm just saying.
Anyway, just Hasbro, you're weird at times. You're really, really weird. Anyway, let us know what you think of the Star Wars Celebration reveals up until Saturday, kind of 9 a.m. And of course, head on to Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries and Matt's other pages and check out the really cool toy photographers who end up posing Hasbro figures. So it's a good bunch of people to watch. And I think that's us.
I think it is.
See you for 113 coming up soon. Bye.
Bye.